Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Everyone ready for tonight's Black Knight Awards? We thank everyone for coming out to this 2015 Black Knight Awards, a celebration of everything that our cadet athletes here at Albany West Point have accomplished over the past year. We have a fantastic evening lineup for you. My name is Rich DeMarco. I'll be your master of ceremonies for tonight's program. And not only will we hand out some very deserving awards, we will relive some of the most celebrated moments over the last 10 months. I see so many familiar faces in the crowd. Thank you all for coming out tonight. Especially, would like to thank General Caslin and his wife Shelley, General Thompson, his wife Holly, General Trainer Colonel Brazel, as well as Colonel Merkel and Mr. Alistair Merkel, Colonel Green, his wife Tara, Colonel Drago, his wife Liz, and Command Sergeant Major Rippelmeyer for taking time out of their busy schedules to join us for this evening's festivities. It's an honor to welcome you and all of our special guests, and thank you for providing such tremendous support throughout the year. I truly speak on behalf of everyone in this room when I say it's greatly appreciated from all our coaches, administrators, and cadet athletes. I'd now like to invite Director of Intercollegiate Athletics, Boo Corrigan, to the stage to officially open tonight's program. Ladies and gentlemen, Boo Corrigan.
I would welcome General Caslin, Mr. Caslin, General Trainer, Colonel Brazel, General Thompson, Holly, Command Sergeant Major Rippelmeyer, thank you for being here. Colonels, thank you very much for being here. Not that there's a lot of colonels here, but I didn't want to leave anyone out. So I got a confession to make. The night that we did the rebrand, and all y'all were there and everyone was excited, I walked out onto that stage and I had like five things I was going to say. And I turned the corner and I walked out, I could not see anything. It was these huge banks of light and smoke. So all I could come up with was, yeah, this is great. So I apologize, I'm a little bit more articulate than that on most nights. Thank you, this is a great night for all of us. To everyone who's made it to this point, congratulations. To the firsties that are gonna graduate and commission, a big congratulations. I'm gonna come back to you in a minute, because I want to talk about something of who we are. When you look at the year, we had five coaches of the year. We had three teams make the NCAA tournament. We had wrestling beat Navy for the first time in 17 years. Congratulations. In a really incredible event, those of you that were there, it really kind of spoke to the spirit of what ODIA is all about, and overcoming and not giving up and not worrying about what the other people are doing, but be the best that we can be. And that's what it comes down to. I do want to recognize a couple of people while I'm up here, because there's some people that are leaving us this year that have been with us for a couple of years. Captain Ian Welsh, I don't know if Ian is here or not, is leaving us. He's been in the athletic department for the last couple of years. Lieutenant Colonel Chad Bagley, Chad Davis is leaving us as well. I don't know if Chad is here. Here he is in the back. Chad, good luck in Italy. Thank you. We appreciate all you've done. Lieutenant Colonel Reno Arredondo is here up front. He's leaving us. Headed back. There's one other person that I want to recognize. She's going to shoot me if she knows about this. Maddie Silvani. Come on. Come on. Come on up here. So what people may not know about Maddie is that Maddie has worked at West Point for 52 years. I'm gonna make this stand right here, and we're gonna look in that camera and smile, all right? But after 52 years, Maddie's going to retire in September, and it's been my great privilege to have been your athletic director for the last 4 years, and I wish you nothing but the best. Thank you. So as I look at this year, we were in this in Rob Aud 10 months ago, and we had John Gordon come in, talking about the energy bus, and talk about energy vampires, and staying positive, and everything that we need to do. And you follow that up, and the captains went to Gettysburg this year. And the Gettysburg trip, and what that provided to the captains, I think the fall captains have already gone this year, and what a great thrill that's been for them. I was looking at some numbers the other day, and I was looking at the last 4 years of wins and losses in the athletic department. And over these last 4 years, we have the highest winning percentage we've had across every sport for a 4 year period as we have since 1994, 95. And we talk a lot about goals at West Point. And we talk a lot about standards at West Point. And we want to win every time out when we're in a goal. We want to get that 4.0 every time. We want to get the A in Buckner every time. But you give it all you can, and sometimes you don't reach your goal. The standard is what the standard is. And that's who we are as an athletic department. That's who we are in the dean's office. That's who we are in the comms office. That's who we are with character. And I want the seniors to stand up right now. If you would, please. Stay up for 1 second. Stay up for 1 second. Because here's the deal. Here's the deal, folks. Ladies and gentlemen, here's the deal. There's a new standard, all right? If you're a Cal, if you're a Yuck, or you're a Plebe, what do you want your standard to be? Do you want it to be going back 20 years on what it is? I don't. I want to keep moving forward with what we're doing. I want to keep moving forward with positions in the core. I want to keep moving forward with scholarship winners. And this class has set a new standard for us. So to the seniors, congratulations on setting the new standard. 1, 2, congratulations on graduating. And 3, congratulations on commissioning. Thank you very much.
Thank you. We ask that the remaining on stage guys will honor several individuals who earned outstanding honors throughout this year. If you are in attendance and we call your name, we please ask that you make your way to the stage to receive an athletic director's coin. Also, please remain on the stage till all names have been called, and I ask our audience hold applause until the end of each category. Well, first up, let's honor our League Major Award winners from the 2014-2015 season. Carolyn Bachrach, Patriot League Volleyball Rookie of the Year. Winston Bolt, Patriot League Men's Soccer Goalkeeper of the Year. Nathan Goff, ECAC Men's Gymnastics Rookie of the Year. Colin McGee, Rugby East Forward of the Year, ACRC Most Valuable Player. Casey McCravey, Patriot League Softball, Defensive Player of the Year. Tyler Fan, Atlantic Hockey Association, Rookie of the Year. And Sam Summers, Patriot League Men's Lacrosse, Goalkeeper of the Year. At this time, we'd like to now recognize those individuals who earned Scholar Athlete of the Year honors in their respective sports. Alex Van Belzer, men's tennis, and Will Deanna, men's swimming and diving. To recognize Kelsey Manon of the women's basketball team, who earned WBCA All-America honors. While we recognize that tonight is all about the cadet athletes, we cannot let the following accomplishments go unnoticed. Will the following coaches make their way to the stage at this time? These outstanding mentors were rewarded with Coach of the Year honors in 2014-2015. Carmen Giglio, Assistant Gymnastics Coach. Rick Johnson, Assistant Rifle Coach. Mike Mahan, Head Men's Rugby Coach. Carl Stray, Assistant Gymnastics Coach. And Doug Van Everen, Head Gymnastics Coach. Put your hands together for all of our NCAA individual participants. Finally, I'd like to welcome up the captains of the following teams. All three won their respective conference titles, and one earned a coveted berth to the NCAA tournament. Gymnastics, ECAC champions, NCAA qualifier. Men's rugby, Rugby East champions. And women's rugby, ACRA Sevens champions. A job very well done for all of our players and coaches. How about a round of applause for all of our award winners and all of our champions. Thank you. So with that, let's get the video portion of tonight's program rolling along. Can't think of a better way to kick things off than with some of our Play of the Year nominees, followed by your favorite and mine, some of the best bloopers of 2014-2015.
Football. Larry Dixon explodes for a 45-yard touchdown run in the season-opening win over Buffalo. Golf. Dean Sakata sinks a long putt on the 17th hole to clinch the star match against Navy. Women's soccer. Jordan Casalia makes two saves on a penalty kick in follow-up chance versus American. Hockey. Parker Gahagan makes two saves, including a diving stop versus Sacred Heart. Men's basketball. Tanner Omlet steal and one-handed slam in traffic at Marist. Wrestling. Logan Everett's takedown in the star match win over Navy. Football. Sean Callahan scores three times in the black and gold spring game.
I think it's a lot different. It really ties together a lot better, you know. So,
it felt like we finished well there again, and you can cut all that crap out.
Just kick me out. Maybe you do
something. It's awkward because I know they're staring at me. Sorry.
And this game is no upset.
No exception.
Thank you. No. This game is no exception.
Sing rejoice all together.
Larry Dixon, Army.
He's asked me like eight childhood memories, and I don't know any of them.
Oh, Dick behind the map. Wait, whoa, that's wrong. What's wrong with you guys?
Happy Thanksgiving from the brothers Arm and Rest Rugby.
It's
Arm and
Rest Rugby.
Damn it, Seth. No, I said it right.
Going on vacation with my family? Question mark.
You know where.
I'm very proud of the tea for me.
Okay. You won't.
Army West Point Women's Rugby. Take
that. There's literally two different lines and you just have to say la 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 la
la. Oh, I want a cool like hidden sub message, like some Illuminati stuff.
We now are camping.
Baby Teresa.
Let me focus on this interview. What am I supposed to say?
You will meet an unexpected guest later.
This is Army Women's Rugby wishing everyone a happy Thanksgiving.
Let's get it together.
Ready?
That was terrible. Oh, Foley, I could do better than that about Foley.
Yeah, I mean, Jesus, there's about only two words you could take out of there that were any good.
I have to go with that.
Let's do the first four. You take Deck the Halls.
Oh my God.
Wow.
You have crazy eyes and a walking head.
Yeah.
All
right. Wait. You have to cut that out. I just have to check.
How's your first stuff playing? This is one long
outtake. Just cut it out.
Now I'd like to welcome head women's basketball coach Dave McGarry to the stage to present our next award. Which is given annually in memory of a young woman who inspired every single person around her. That's late Army women's basketball coach Maggie Dixon. Before her sudden passing in 2006, she was known for her fearlessness, her competitiveness, and her true passion for sport. Tonight, we honor our cadet athletes who showcase that very spirit each and every day. Before we get to the winner, here are tonight's finalists. Jesse Glenn, gymnastics. Olivia Schretzman, women's basketball. And Chandler Smith, wrestling. And the winner of the 2015 Maggie Dixon Inspiration Award is Chandler Smith. While suffering a torn ligament in his hand, Chandler stepped up to the challenge of wrestling Navy's best wrestler. In the words of his head coach, Kevin Ward, Chandler's injury forced him into wrestling with one hand. He has consistently been a team leader and embodies the values of what the Maggie Dixon Award represents. A willingness to always challenge himself and a love of competition. Ladies and gentlemen, Chandler Smith. At this time, I'd now like to invite Associate Athletic Director Gaylord Green to the stage to present the Gene U. Chaz Memorial Award. The Army West Point Athletics family lost a tireless worker, an invaluable member of our staff, and more importantly, a wonderful friend 5 years ago. Those of you who knew Gene U. Chaz knew his smile, knew his jokes, and perhaps most importantly, knew his undying love for the Boston Red Sox and his distaste for the Navy midshipmen. Gene was a behind-the-scenes guy, never looking for public praise or gratitude, but always there to lend a hand no matter what anyone needed. Just over 5 years ago, Gene lost a 10-month battle with lymphoma, and the athletic department family lost a dear friend. At that time, it was decided that an award would be given in his memory at this event. Gene embodied the true meaning of being a team player, and all of tonight's nominees for the Gene U. Chaz Memorial Award have that same spirit. The nominees are Ellen Duckwall, women's soccer, Chandler Smith, wrestling, and Will Vianna, men's swimming and diving. And the winner of the Gene U. Chaz Memorial Award is Will Vianna. In and out of the pool throughout his 4 years. His dedication to the team has never wavered, and he is a mentor, role model, and supporter to the team. Will is always eager to share his experiences with his teammates and has taken many of them to Europe to expose them to the culture he grew up in. Will has most recently planned a European trip with his fellow firsties, which will include working a summer camp through the European Forces Swim League. He's constantly looked to share his value of selfless service and previously set up a Habitat for Humanity retreat for the team prior to its annual meet with Navy. Ladies and gentlemen, congratulations once again to Will Vianna. Our next award tonight focuses on giving back, and right now I'd like to invite Assistant Athletic Director Ryan Yanishak to the stage to present the Community Service Award. The list of community service projects our cadet athletes have participated in is certainly not lacking for length. With several of our cadet athletes have spent many generous hours out in the community and helping to better our society at home and abroad, one stands above the rest. Our winner spent his spring break volunteering with medical missions for children in Rwanda. He joined his father and mother, Paul and Nancy, as the group traveled to a hospital. The Newton, Massachusetts native documented the trip with a blog of the group's week-long excursion to the East African country. Ladies and gentlemen, this year's Community of Service Award goes to men's rugby firstie, Nicholas Sattlitz. Congratulations, Nicholas. Before we move move on to the rest of the show, it's important to point out that while we will be seeing video highlights of our award finalists tonight, a complete listing of all nominees for each of our remaining categories can be found in tonight's program. Now let's keep the show moving along with the awards. When Peter Kim, last year's Men's Rookie of the Year winner, please join me on stage to present this year's award. The plebe year at West Point is often the most challenging of the 4 years, so it's even more impressive that these cadets were able to maintain an immediate impact on their respective teams in their first season. Please direct your attention to the video screen for a look at the Men's Rookie of the Year finalists. Nathan Goff, gymnastics. Goff was the ECAC Rookie of the Year, earning 43 top 10 finishes, including 21 top 5 marks. Goff had 5 top 10 marks in the star meet over Navy, where he took the individual title on pommel horse with a score of 14.5. Tyler Pham, hockey. Pham was Army West Point's leading scorer with 29 points on 9 goals and 20 assists, and led rookies in Atlantic hockey in points, and was 5th nationally in points per game among freshmen. Pham became the first Black Knight to win Atlantic Hockey Rookie of the Year and was a member of the conference's all-rookie team. Josh Martin, rifle. Martin tied the Academy's small bore mark of 591 and earned medalist honors at the President's Trophy match, ranking tops in the country at the time and just 1 point off the leader at season's end. Martin also earned medalist honors in air rifle in the star win over Navy. That award goes to Tyler Pham. This is Tyler's first nomination and first Black Knight Award win. A native of Fort Collins, Colorado, he is a member of Company G1. For Women's Rookie of the Year.
Carolyn Bockrath, volleyball. Bockrath was the Patriot League Rookie of the Year, a second-team all-conference selection, and two-time League Rookie of the Week, leading the conference with a 390 hitting percentage, which was the 10th best single-season percentage in Patriot League history and second in Academy history. Bockrath finished tops on the Black Knights in blocks and second in kills. Bria Brown, track and field. Brown's vault of 15.05 meters in the shot put ranks first in outdoor Academy history and was good for second place at the Patriot League Championships. She posted a mark of 14.48 meters at the indoor championship, good for second in Academy history. Brown placed in the top 10 in 27 of her 28 events during both the indoor and outdoor seasons, capturing 8 first place titles and finishing in the top 5 in all 13 shot put attempts. Nicole Heverlin, rugby. Heverlin joined the rugby team in the spring semester after previously being a member of the basketball squad and made an immediate impact, posting 8 tries on the season along with 30 conversions and 100 total points in sevens action.
And the Black Knight Award goes to Carolyn Bockrath. This is Carolyn's first nomination and first Black Knight Award win. A native of Newport Beach, California, Carolyn is a member of Company C3. Congratulations to Carol and the entire volleyball team on consecutive Rookie of the Year awards. Now, Kyle Wilson, last year's Men's Yearling of the Year make his way to the stage to present as we check out the best that our yearlings had to offer in 2014-2015. First up, Men's Yearling of the Year.
Russell Parsons, wrestling. Parsons finished the year with 27 overall victories to rank second on the team and made his first NCAA championship appearance after missing last season due to an injury. Parsons won the 157 title at the New York State Championships and the All-Academy Championships and earned a 7-1 win in the 157 match against Navy to help the Black Knights to a 21-10 victory. Grant Reekman, tennis. Reekman was named to the All-Patriot League second team and led Army West Point with 19 overall singles victories and 13 dual match wins. Third on the team with 15 doubles victories in dual matches, Reekman competed primarily at number 3 singles and number 2 doubles and went 4-1 in singles against Patriot League opponents while finishing 5-0 in doubles during conference play. Jeremy Timpf, football. Timpf was named to the ECAC Division I FBS All-Star Team and was selected to Phil Steele's postseason All-Independent Team and the FBS All-Independent Team at linebacker. Starting all 12 games, Timpf led Army West Point with 117 tackles, including 14.5 tackles for loss and 79 solo stops, which were tied for 11th most in a single season in Academy history.
And the Black Knight Award goes to Jeremy Timpf. This is Jeremy's first nomination and first Black Knight Award win. A native of Tucson, Arizona, he's a member of Company H4. Accepting the award on Jeremy's behalf is head coach Jeff Munkin. Before we move on, I'd like to welcome Associate Athletic Director Brian White to the stage to present as we take a look at the three finalists for Women's Yearling of the Year.
Jordan Casalia, soccer. Casalia posted 9 saves, 6 in the second half, including a double save on a penalty kick in a 2-1 win over league rival American. In addition to posting a career-best 15 saves against Delaware, Casalia closed out the year tops in the Patriot League and ranking among the national leaders in saves and saves per game. Allison Haley, tennis. Haley earned the most singles wins on the team during the 2014-2015 season with 20 and was 4-1 against Patriot League opponents and played 2 matches at the number 2 singles spot. With a 7-3 mark in doubles play, Haley ended the season on a 3-match winning streak. Caroline Smith, softball. Smith appeared in 32 games in the circle with 25 games started and picked up 12 wins, including 6 in Patriot League play, as well as a save in 152 and 2/3 innings pitch. Smith, who was named to the Patriot League All-Tournament team, was equally as impressive at the plate, finishing 3rd on the team with a .322 batting average.
And the Black Knight Award goes to Allison Haley. This is Allison's first nomination and first Black Knight Award win. Native of Houston, Texas. She's a member of Company A4. Congratulations on a great sophomore season, Allison. All right, we've spent some time tonight looking at individual plays and how much of an impact they can have on a game. But how about performances? A player or team stepping up for a key game or tournament, or just simply having the game of his or her career, are just as important. With Executive Athletic Director Bob Beretta presenting on stage. Right now, let's check out the finalists for Men's Performance of the Year.
Chris Carnegie, football versus Connecticut. Carnegie made 5 tackles, intercepted 2 passes, including the game-sealing 99-yard interception return for a touchdown in Army West Point's 35-21 victory over Connecticut at Yankee Stadium, which was the Black Knights' first win in the Bronx since 1960. Alex Robinette, baseball versus Air Force. Robinette set an academy record with 21 strikeouts in Army West Point's 8-0 win over Air Force. The senior righty gave up 3 hits, did not walk a batter, and struck out at least 2 hitters in every inning. He struck out the side 3 times and broke the previous record of 17 with 5 Ks to end the game. Wrestling versus Navy. The Black Knights ended a 17-year drought in the Star Series by defeating Navy 21-10 on February 22nd at Crystal Arena. Army West Point posted wins in 7 of the 10 matches, including the 141 match, when sophomore Logan Everett earned a late takedown to secure a 5-2 victory and clinch the match.
And the Black Knight Award goes to Alex Robinette for his outstanding performance in striking out an academy record 21 times in an 8-0 victory over Air Force. This is Alex's 3rd nomination and first Black Knight Award win. A native of Bend, Oregon, he is a member of Company C1 and accepting on behalf of Alex's teammate, Brock Davidson. Before we move on, I'd like to welcome Associate Athletic Director Gene McIntyre to the stage to present our next award. Here are the 3 finalists for Women's Performance of the Year.
Bria Brown, outdoor track and field at Navy. Brown broke the Army-Navy outdoor meet shot put record with a mark of 14.65 meters en route to a first place finish over the midshipmen. Brown recorded 2 first place nods on the afternoon, also placing first in the hammer throw. Kelsey Minato, basketball versus Lehigh. Minato went 8 for 12 from 3-point range and 7 of 7 from the foul line to finish with a game-high 33 points in the Patriot League semifinals against the Mountain Hawks. Minato's 8 three-pointers matched her own academy record for a single game. She also finished with 4 rebounds and 3 steals while playing 36 minutes. Women's Rugby at the American Collegiate Rugby Association Championships. The Black Knights completed a 6-0 weekend in the ACRA Sevens Championships at Anderson Rugby Complex. Army West Point knocked off each of its opponents, including a 22-7 victory in the championship game over top-ranked and defending champion Norwich, which entered the tournament on a 63-game unbeaten streak.
And the Black Knight Award goes to the women's rugby team for winning the ACRA Sevens tournament championship. Accepting the award on behalf of the women's rugby team is team captain Ashley Moore. Our awards. Let's take one more look back at some more of the lighter moments caught on camera this past season.
Come on, I just have to get my bicep band on.
We play them really well, and not only at home but also at American. So we have.
Do this today.
Indian weather.
Oh, la, 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 la.
Okay, this was bad.
Hi.
Logan will go with you.
Army.
Are we getting ice cream back to this mom?
No, that's wrong. That's really wrong.
What's your favorite book and why?
Jimbo can't read.
Hiccup time.
John, that's my head.
Poor idiot. Oh my word.
Yeah, we can definitely do heavy metal.
Scream out in here.
Just an idiot.
Fast away then, all you asses!
Do I look at the camera?
Take one. It's gonna be about. It'll be three takes.
All right, usually good about it.
All right.
See the
blade.
I know.
It's about, like, oh my god, that's a huge bird. Bird is huge.
I don't eat candy, no, none of us eat candy. Sorry.
There's
the
hole.
Yeah,
that's what you did.
Okay, that's the hole. I did say.
Don't,
me not, art, did, don't, they, don't.
Oh my god,
one more time,
oh my gosh, I gotta tell you something, and then they go,
never mind. This is great, you're such
a wild. I like the Cleveland Indians, cause, you played there?
Yeah, you really like them, right?
You know, much different. I mean, nice change.
A lot of my range.
Here, some sugar, baby.
Don't.
Yeah, you need a little bit of that.
A little bit of sugar, I appreciate that.
Yeah, well.
Now I'm stopping. The halls with boughs of holly. Fa la 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 la.
Help, I'm trapped in a Chinese fortune cookie factory.
You're in the 5K. Can we start over?
It's going right now, yeah.
Is it really? That's gonna go in the booth.
Is this going in the.
Nice job there. The cameras are always rolling. And let's keep the awards rolling with firstly Larry Dixon, last year's winner in our next category. Make his way to the stage as we present the 2015 Black Knight Award for Play of the Year. Had so many to choose from. Let's take a look at our remaining nominees.
Sprint football. J.J. Wartzke's 64-yard touchdown pass to Tucker Van Dyke in a rout of Cornell. Men's rugby. Colin McGee intercepts a pass and goes 40 yards for the try against Navy. Football. Josh Jenkins' block punt and Xavier Moss's recovery for a touchdown against Navy. Men's basketball. Tanner Plum catches an alley-oop from Milton, Washington at American. Men's lacrosse. Connor Cook scores a behind-the-back goal versus Bucknell. Women's basketball. Kelsey Minato scores with a reverse layup against American.
And the Black Knight Award goes to Logan Everett for his takedown against Navy in his first star win since 1996-97 in wrestling. Gonna look at it one more time. This is Logan's first nomination and first Black Knight Award win. A native of Tioga, Pennsylvania, he is a member of Company F3. What a day that was for Logan and Black Knights and Crystal Ridge. Congratulations. It's an afternoon and evening that won't soon be forgotten. Would first need Jack Glessner, last year's winner in our next category, please join me on stage to present this year's Men's Cow of the Year. And the finalists are.
Jesse Glenn, gymnastics. Glenn captured his third consecutive all-around title at the West Point Open and earned 7 top 3 finishes in leading Army West Point to the star victory over Navy. An ECAC All-Academic Team honoree, Glenn was the only Black Knight to advance to the individual finals of the NCAA Championships, where he finished 9th on the high bar. Tanner Plum, basketball. Plum was an All-Patriot League second team selection and also was named to the conference's second team by College Sports Madness. A member of the All-Military Classic All-Tournament team, Plum finished second on the Black Knights in scoring and rebounding, averaging 15.7 points and 5.7 carats per game. Chris Zekley, swimming and diving. Zekley was an All-Patriot League first-team selection and was the top performer at the Patriot League Championships, with the most individual points earned of any competitor. Zekley swept the sprint events, earning first place in both the 50 and 100 freestyle, and earned an NCAA B-cut time. In the 100 free, he clocked an academy record-setting time of 43.81 seconds.
And the Black Knight Award goes to Jesse Glenn. This is Jesse's second nomination and first Black Knight Award win. A native of Porter Ranch, California, he is a member of Company C. Congratulations. Now let's turn our attention to the ladies' side of things as last year's winner, Ellie Taylor, comes to the stage to present Women's Cal of the Year. And the three finalists are.
Katie Holder, soccer. Holder started all 18 matches and led the Black Knights in goals, points, game winners, and shots to also rank among the conference leaders. At All-Patriot League First Team selection, Holder was voted to the Capital One Academic All-District One team and was an Academic All-Patriot League selection. Kelsey Minato, basketball. Minato led the Patriot League in scoring, three-pointers per game, and three-point percentage, while ranking eighth nationally in both scoring average and free-throw percentage. At All-Patriot League first-team selection, Minato was a WBCA All-America Honorable Mention selection, becoming just the sixth Army West Point player to earn All-America honors, and the third at the Division I level. Casey McCravey, softball. McCravey was named the Patriot League Defensive Player of the Year and was a first-team All-Conference selection, leading the Patriot League in hits, total bases, and stolen bases, and tied for most runs scored. McCravey also swatted eight home runs and ripped grand slams against Holy Cross and Boston University.
And the Black Knight Award goes to Kelsey Minato. This is Kelsey's sixth nomination for Black Knight Award winner. A native of Huntington Beach, California, she's a member of Company C4. Accepting the award on Kelsey's behalf is head coach Dave McGarry. At this time, I'd like to welcome back to the stage Director of Athletics, Boo Corrigan, to present our three biggest awards of the night. Let's get things started with the three finalists for Men's First Team of the Year.
Winston Bolt, soccer. Bolt finished the season with eight shutouts and helped lead Army West Point to its first Patriot League tournament victory since 1996. Earning Patriot League Goalkeeper of the Year and All-League First Team honors for the second season in a row, Bolt also was named an NSCAA Division I Scholar Second Team All-America and was a finalist for the Senior Class Award. Larry Dixon, football. Dixon was named to the ECAC Division I FBS All-Star Team, as well as Phil Steele's postseason All-Independent Team. Starting all 12 games, Dixon was named to the FBS All-Independent Team at running back, finishing the season with 190 carries for 1,102 yards, 5.8 yards per carry, and 9 touchdowns. John Glessner, lacrosse. Lesnar was an All-Patriot League first-team selection and was a top 25 finalist for the Towerton Award, given to the best college lacrosse player in the country. Glessner was tops on Army West Point with 57 points on 34 goals and a team-best 23 assists in leading the Black Knights to the championship game of the Patriot League tournament.
And the Black Knight Award goes to John Glessner. This is John's third nomination and third Black Knight Award. A native of Camillus, New York, he's a member of Company C4. Congratulations, John, on what's been a great season and career here at Army West Point. Now let's take a look at the three finalists for Women's First Team of the Year.
Kate Roos, rugby. Roos led Army West Point in the fall with 19 tries, posting a second place mark of 95 points in 15's action. In the spring, Roos led the Sevens team with 20 tries for a total of 90 points and scored the game winner in stoppage time of the USA Sevens Rugby Tournament in Las Vegas. Olivia Schretzman, basketball. Schretzman was an All-Patriot League third-team selection and was Army West Point's leading rebounder and second-leading scorer in helping the Black Knights reach postseason for the third straight year. Schretzman's 6.5 rebounds per game were second most during her career, while her 10 points per game were a career best. Elle Taylor, tennis. Taylor was named to the Patriot League All-Academic Team after a season in which she notched 35 total victories, including 26 in doubles action. Taylor, a team co-captain, went 6-1 in doubles against conference foes and graduates with 152 total wins, including 92 in doubles.
And the Black Knight Award goes to Olivia Schretzman. This is Olivia's first nomination and first Black Knight Award. A native of Dayton, Ohio, she's a member of Company H4. The moment you've all been waiting for. Time for our final award of the evening, our best picture or entertainer of the year. And something new this year, we'd like to thank the class of 1970. They've donated a gift which will be placed in the Friends of account of our team of the year, with the award now being the MacArthur Award. With that, here are our three finalists for the MacArthur Award, presented to our team of the year.
Gymnastics. The Black Knights captured their first ECAC title in 10 years and earned the conference's automatic bid to the NCAA championships. Junior Jesse Glenn won titles in the all-around, vault, parallel bars, and high bars. Army West Point also earned a star match victory over arch-rival Navy. Men's rugby. Army West Point finished its fall season 8-1 to qualify for the Spring National Championship playoffs, where the Black Knights reached the Elite Eight. Army West Point won 7 of its 9 games in the spring to finish with a 15-3 overall record. Women's rugby. The Black Knights took the American Collegiate Rugby Association Championship, defeating 3-time defending champion Norwich, which was riding a 63-match unbeaten streak. In addition to the ACRA title, Army West Point also won the USA Rugby Sevens Virginia Beach Tournament.
And the Black Knight Award goes to men's rugby. to accept the award. We originally were planning on having a member of the class of 1970 present the award. We had a unique situation. Mike Mahan was supposed to present it on behalf of the class of 1970, but of course, receiving it as part of the men's rugby team, our MacArthur Award winner for Team of the Year. Congratulations to the men's rugby team on a tremendous season. We look forward to cheering you all on again next year. While we don't have any more hardware to give out tonight, the celebration not completely over yet. A lot of members of the team up here. Great presentation. Before we depart tonight, join me as we take a look back at some of the best moments of what's been a memorable year. Sit back, relax, enjoy this tremendous highlight film put together by our own Zach Daly. Roll it.
Is all it will take. We'll go down in history.
if you're holding one of those Black Knight Awards in your hands, don't leave just yet. Please come up to the stage for a quick group photo before you depart. Once again, Black Knight Award winners, please make their way to the stage. Ladies and gentlemen, that'll do it for this year's Black Knight Awards. Thank you for everyone who had a hand in making this such a huge success. Congratulations. Best of luck to all the members of the West Point Class of 2015 as graduation week commences. For those of you returning, we'll see you again next year. Have a great rest of your night, everyone.